Prusa Slicer provides a tool which lets you paint directly on an imported 3D model and select areas where supports should be generated. Let's look at the tool in more detail. The Paint on Supports tool is available in the left toolbar, but only in the Advanced and Expert modes. If you're in the Simple mode, you will not see it. So I will switch into the Advanced mode, and after you select the model, you can enable the Paint on Supports tool. If there are any other objects on the build plate, they will be hidden, and the object will be shaded in light gray, so that the painting is just really easy to spot. The controls are explained in the context menu, so you can paint supports with your left mouse button, you can paint support blockers with right mouse button, and you can erase both blockers and enforcers with shift and left mouse button. You can also change the size of the cursor, either by using the slider right here, or you can use Alt and your mouse scroll wheel. There are two cursors available, the default sphere one and a circle one. You're most likely going to be using pretty much just the sphere one. The way it works is it paints everything inside the sphere that you can see in the preview. So if I paint support enforcers right here, you can see that it also paints the bottom of the mouth. Basically, it kind of behaves how you would expect it to. If I erase it all and I switch to the circle cursor, this only paints everything that's visible to the camera at the moment, so it sort of projects the painting from the camera. So if I do the same painting, you can see that there are now faces that are not painted. And also this whole part is unpainted, and that's because from the side those faces are not visible. So you probably want to just leave it switched to sphere. There's also the clipping of view tool, which is also available in combination with several other tools in Prusa Slicer. What that does is it enables you to hide part of the model so that you can get an easier access to the painted area. So for example here, if I wanted to paint this mouth from the bottom, you can see that it's now obscured by the stand of the statue. So what I can do is look from the bottom, move the slider a bit, I'll click reset direction, and now the clipping plane will move from bottom to top. So I can hide most of the model, and now painting the mouth is really easy. And then I can just reveal it back. If I, for example, wanted to hide the model from the side, I would just look it from the side, click reset direction, and now the slider cuts the model from the side. There are also two buttons in the context menu. The first one is auto set by angle, and this provides real-time visualization of overhangs. So as you drag the slider more to the right, it marks more and more areas as being overhanging, and if you drag it to the left, it shows just the most extreme overhangs. This can be really useful to spot the areas where you might want to paint enforcers. If you see that the overhanging area is really small, such as these, that's probably fine and the printer can print those without supports. But big spots like these, those are candidates for supports, maybe even these two. Not only you can use it to visualize the overhangs, but you can also use it to paint the enforcers. This is now still editable, so you can, for example, erase the parts that you think are unnecessary to have supports, but this can this is basically painted automatically. The other button is remove all selection. That's pretty self-explanatory. Whatever you have painted on the model, this button will just erase it all. When you're using Paint on Supports, it's important to actually turn supports on. Right now we have set supports to none, so even if we paint any enforcers, no supports will be generated. The setting that makes probably the most sense if you're using enforcers is for support enforcers only. If we set it to that, well, right now only the painted areas will get support. You can look at the preview, and if you think it's maybe a little bit too much, you can just adjust it and the supports will regenerate. You can also use the paint on support in combination with the automatically generated supports. So in this case, we are going to set supports to everywhere, but we are going to set the overhang threshold really low, so that only the critical overhangs are supported by the automatic supports. So if you look into the preview, you can see that really only essentially what we'd consider an island is supported. And now we can mark some additional areas that we think might need supports, like this X, for example. And those will simply be added to the existing supports. If we want to use support blockers, first we actually need some supports to be generated. So let's change supports to everywhere. And let's check the preview and see what we get. So that is a lot of support. So let's try to lower the overhang threshold, see if that helps. So I set it to 15 degrees for now. And let's see, that looks much better. But we can see that some parts of the model got supports, even though they're probably not necessary. For example, up here around the hair area. So let's turn on paint on supports. And using the right mouse button, I'm going to paint red. So that's support blockers. And if I now switch into preview, the supports are gone. By the way, I'm constantly using the tab key to switch between the G-code preview and the 3D scene mode. So that's just a really quick way to, you know, paint blockers. You press tab, you go into the G-code preview, and you can see that the supports are now gone on this side of the face. Of course, nothing is stopping you from using both blockers and enforcers at the same time. So let's say that you really wanted to block them here, but maybe around this arm you think that it needs more supports. So you can paint with the left mouse button, and you can see that now there are more supports around here. So you can absolutely use both at the same time. It might be necessary with some very complex models to get supports exactly where you need them. When you're painting, you can use undo and redo, just like normally in Prusa Slicer. One thing to keep in mind is that while you are in the paint on supports tool, there is a basically separate history of the steps of everything, every stroke that you painted. Once you close the tool, all of these steps are basically merged into a single step in the undo history. So that is just something to keep in mind. Another nice thing about paint on supports is that they are saved in the FreeMF project file. So if you go into file, save project, the paint on supports now got saved in the FreeMF. And if we now reload the file, for example, by using recent projects, you can see that when I go into paint on supports, the painted areas are still there. So this is very useful, both for you, if you're just for future reference in case you'll be printing or modifying this print in the future, and also in the case that you'll be sharing the files online, so others that download the file will be able to easily see your painted supports and modify them if necessary. Paint on supports are covered in the Prusa Slicer documentation, which you can find at help.prusa3d.com. Happy printing!